The Colgate Comedy Hour. Starring...
My wall club, Lou.
Hey, all those people going to be at the game today?
Certainly.
Oh, this is going to be a whopper of a game.
Well, it should be.
Hey, yeah, but what? I understand they made you the manager of this here Colgate team.
Why not?
So you're the manager?
I'm the manager.
Well, you know, I'd like to know some of the guys' names on the team, so when I meet them on the street or in the ballpark, I'll be able to say hello to those people.
Why, sure, I'll introduce you to the boys. They give them funny names, though, Lou.
Oh, I know. They give those ball players awful funny names.
Now, let's see. On the team, we have who's on first, what's on second, I don't know who's on third.
You the manager?
Yes.
You know the guys' names?
I should.
Well, then tell me the guys' names.
I say who's on first, what's on second, I don't know who's on third.
You the manager?
And then yes.
You know the guys' names?
I'm telling you their names.
Well, who's on first?
Yes.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
Who?
The guy on first.
Who?
The guy playing first base.
Who?
The guy on first.
Who is on first?
What are you asking me for? I'm asking you.
I'm not asking you. I'm telling you.
You ain't telling me nothing. I'm asking you who's on first.
That's it.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
Who?
The guy on first base.
That's his name.
That's whose name?
Yes.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
That's the man's name.
That's whose name?
Yes.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
Who is on first?
What are you asking me for? I'm asking you who's on first.
That's it.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
Who?
The guy on first.
That's it.
What's the guy's name on first?
No, what's on second?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
That's what I'm asking you.
No,
who's on first?
Don't change the place.
I'm not changing nobody. I ask you a simple question. What's the guy's name on first base?
What's the guy's name on second
base? I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who is on first?
I don't know.
He's on third. Now, we're not talking about him.
Look, you got a first baseman?
Yes.
Then tell me the fella's name playing first.
Who?
The guy playing first.
That's his name.
Wait. What's the guy's name on first base?
Why, there's the guy's name on second base.
Who's playing second?
Who's playing first?
I don't know.
He's on third base. What's the matter with you, can't you?
Look, when you pay off the first baseman every month, who do you pay the money to?
Every dollar.
Yeah. Look, you got to pay the money to somebody on first base,
yes.
Don't you? Does he give you a receipt?
Sure.
How does he sign the receipt?
Who?
The guy that you give the money to.
Who?
The guy you give the money to.
That's how he signs.
That's how who signs?
Yes.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
That's it.
That's who?
Yes.
When you give the guy the money, don't he have to sign the receipt?
He does, Lou.
Well, how does he sign his name?
Who?
The guy you give the money to.
That's how he signs it. Who?
You dope.
Now, take it easy.
You just don't give money to somebody without him giving you a receipt.
So who signs it?
What are you asking me?
I'm telling you.
Well, go ahead, tell me. What's the guy's name that signs the receipt on first
wait
base?
Wait a minute. What signs his own receipt?
Who signs his own receipt?
No, who signs his?
Well, I'm asking you, when the guy on first base gives you a piece of paper, he puts his name on it.
So who puts his name on it? What puts
How does the fella's name on first base look to you when he signs his name?
Who?
To you.
That's how it looks.
How does it look to you?
Who?
To you.
Who?
To you.
Who?
Look, when the guy signs his name, how does it look to you?
Look, that's how it looks.
Who? I'm asking you, what's the guy's name on first base you give the money to?
Who? After all, the man's entitled to it.
Who is?
Yes. Sometimes his wife comes down and collects it.
Whose wife?
Yeah, sure.
All I'm trying to find out is what's the guy's name on first base?
Well, he's on second base.
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know.
He's
third
on
base. I know that. You got an outfield?
Sure.
The left fielder's name.
Why?
I just thought I'd ask you.
Well, I just thought I'd tell you.
The left fielder's name.
Why? Oh. I don't know these players as well.
All I'm trying to find out is what's the guy's name in left field.
Now, what is on second?
I'm not asking you who's on second.
Who's on first?
I don't know. Third base. You got a pitcher on the team?
Wouldn't this be a fine team without a pitcher?
The pitcher's name?
Tomorrow.
You don't want to tell me the date?
I'm telling you, Logan.
Then go ahead.
Tomorrow.
What time?
What time what?
What time tomorrow are you going to tell me who's pitching?
Now, listen. Who is not...
I'll break your arm, you say, who's on first. I want to know what's the pitcher's name.
What's on second?
I don't know. Third base! You got a catcher?
Sure.
The catcher's name?
Today.
Today. You don't want to tell me today, tomorrow, do you?
I'm telling you.
So the catcher's name?
Today.
Today, and tomorrow's pitching.
Now you've got it.
Now I got it.
Boy, got it. Now stop.
All we got is a couple of days on the
team.
Well,
I can't help that.
All right, you know, now I'm a good catcher. Now I get behind a plate, and tomorrow's pitching on my team, and a heavy hitter gets up.
Yes.
Now when he gets up, me being a good catcher, I'm going to throw the guy out at first base. So the guy bunts the ball, I pick up the ball. I'm going to throw the guy out at first base, so I pick up the ball and throw it to who?
Now that's the first thing you've said right.
I don't even know what I'm talking about.
But that's all you
that's
have.
That's all I do is throw the ball to first base. Now who's got it?
Naturally. Now you got it.
If I throw the ball to first base, somebody's got to get the ball. Now who's got it?
Naturally.
Who?
Naturally.
Naturally?
Naturally.
So I pick up the ball and I throw it to Naturally.
He gets the ball. You throw the ball to first base.
Then who gets it?
Naturally.
So I pick up the ball and I throw it to Naturally.
No.
Naturally
no.
gets the ball and...
You throw the ball to who?
Naturally.
That's
what I'm saying.
You're not saying it that way.
I said I throw the ball to Naturally.
No, you don't.
I throw it to who?
Naturally.
That's what I'm saying. I throw the ball to first base. Somebody's got to get
so
it.
So who gets it?
Naturally. Okay. Now I ask you, who gets it?
Naturally.
Same as you.
No, it's not.
I throw the ball to Naturally.
You throw the ball to who?
Then who gets it?
Naturally.
He better get it. So I throw the ball to first base. All whoever it is drops the ball and the guy runs a second. Now, who picks up the ball and throws it to what?
Yes.
What throws it to I don't know. I don't know, throws it back to tomorrow. Triple play.
Could be.
And now that guy gets up and hits a long fly ball to be caught.
Yes.
Why? I don't know. He's on third and I don't give a darn.
What'd you say?
I said I don't give a darn.
Oh, that's our shortstop. Colonel Frome.
How are you, Mr. Abbott?
Glad to see you. How'd you like the beginning of the show?
Wonderful, Mr. Abbott.
Well,
absolutely excellent. If this is the type of a show you're going to put on, I'm certain Washington is going to approve of it.
Well, that's wonderful, and I hope the USO and the boys enjoy it.
I'm sure they will.
We'll do our very best to put on a big, dynamic show.
I'll bet you will. Thank you very much,
okay,
sir.
Okay, Colonel.
Carry on.
Thanks a lot.
Well, I had to make a fast change. What do you expect, a miracle?
Well, look, what do you want? Why interrupt the show like this?
Where's the red light? Oh!
Come here. What are you doing out here?
I wonder.
You're not supposed to be out here.
I heard you talking to the colonel.
Well, what about it?
What'd the colonel have to say to you?
Hey, what is in Washington?
Income tax?
No.
What for?
For our show. A big show I'm putting on for the USO.
You're going to put a show on for the USO? And they want us for that? Where are you going to get the money?
Well, we'll have to dig it up somewhere.
Hey.
What?
Be a pal. Be a buddy.
Well, I always have been.
Can I sing in a show?
Oh, now, Lou, now you're asking too much. I'll go...
A pretty girl.
No. Not that.
Miss Abbott?
Yeah, that's swell. And I'm going to put you in my show.
Oh, thank you.
Goodness, thank you.
You'll hear from me, boys. Okay, don't worry about a thing. I'll take care of that mail. Hey.
Hey!
What was that for?
You know I made it.
All right, listen.
Hey, look. Those three guys are good for the show, but we're going to put on for the soldiers.
I'm going to put them in.
How about the money?
I can't raise it, Lou.
You can't get the money yet?
I haven't got enough money of my own.
Well, I got money? I got a little bit of money.
How much money have you got?
Well, I got a little bit.
How much?
I got in the neighborhood of about $200.
In the neighborhood?
Well, in the vicinity, I got about $16.
In the vicinity?
Roughly speaking, I got $16.
$16?
When you smooth it out, I got $1.27.
Then you have got $1.20.
Well, yes.
Where have you got it?
I got it scattered all over the country in banks and loans.
I think that. You know, I have an appointment here with my Uncle Charlie.
Yeah.
He is going to try and raise it for us, but...
An idea.
What?
Do you mind if I call up Joe Bozzo? Hey. He lives a block from here, and I'll try to get the money from him.
Joe Bozzo is the boy.
Yeah.
Call him up. We've no stone unturned. We've got to get that money.
I'll get Joe on the phone right now. Hello, operator.
Number, please.
Me, Bryant, 4444, please.
What number?
Bryant, 4444.
What number was that, sir?
Bryant, 44!
What number, sir?
Bryant, 44!
Oh, Bryant, 44444? Oh, you want Bryant 16?
No, ma'am, you don't add them up. Don't add the fours up, lady. They're individual, separate, single, away from each other.
Oh, you want to talk to your mother?
No, I don't want to speak to my mother. I want to speak to Joe Bozzo. I want Bryant, 4444.
Buffalo is a toll call. I'll give you long...
What? Buffalo? I want Bryant, 4444.
I'm sorry, sir. That line is busy.
What do you say so? Line's busy.
Hello. Get me to Santa Fe Railroad Station in Los Angeles, California. I want to talk to Bill Riggs.
Here's your party.
Hello, Bill. This is Detective Murphy. Say, I think I got a line on the guy who stole the locomotive off the super chief. Now, I haven't got the goods on him yet, but the first time he tries to take it out for a ride, brother, will I nail him. Now, goodbye.
How dare you laugh on my birthday?
May I please have Bryant 4444?
I'm sorry, sir. You'll have to speak louder.
Bryant 4444!
I'm sorry, sir. I can't hear you. You'll have to speak a little louder.
If I speak any louder, I will have to call him up. He'll hear me. He only lives a block from here, lady. Bryant 4444!
I'm sorry. That line is busy.
Operator, get me Senor Cordova in Barcelona, Spain.
There's your party.
Hello? Hello? Senor, this is Miss Tipito, your pupil in New York. Yes, the lesson came in the mail this morning. But, Senor, a terrible thing happened. When I was doing the first routine, I busted my castanets. You see, I should just glue it back together. Thank you very much, Senor. Goodbye.
Thank you. head frame.
Like a Billy.
Operation, get me to Kremlin, Moscow, Russia.
Station party.
Hello, Joe? This is Botsky. I got the secret information you wanted. Hold your wire a minute, I'll take a look. It's all right, I'm alone. They got a base in Okinawa, they got a base in Japan, and they got a base in Manchuria. Three bases with good men. All right, Joe. Bye-bye.
Just a minute. I overheard you speaking about three men on bases.
Yeah, that's right.
What's the guy's name on first base?
No, who is on first?
I want to know what's the guy... Get out of here. May I please have Bryant 4444?
What number do you wish, sir?
What I have to do, wish for it now? I would like to have Bryant 4444.
Oh, it's you again. How many times I got to tell you that line is busy? Gee, you can certainly burn up a person.
Oh, what's the matter? You're all wet.
I'm all wet, you're all wet.
I am perfectly dry.
Oh, you're dry, are you?
Yes.
One moment, please.
Okay.
What are you perspiring for?
I just talked to Niagara Falls.
Oh.
This
is my Uncle Charlie. This is my Uncle Charlie. He's got some news.
How do you do?
How do you do,
Mr. Charlie? Costello, I've got good news for you.
How do you feel, Charlie?
How do you feel?
Any minute, we're going to have milk. All
right. Mr. Costello, I've got great news for you.
Explain to him, Uncle Charlie.
I've got a plan that'll raise all the money you boys need for this fine deed you're doing, a show for the
soul. First of all, Uncle Charlie, I don't need the money. Your nephew needs the money. He's going to put a show up for the USO, not me.
All right, okay, well, let him explain it, Lou.
About a few miles from here, out in the desert, is an old deserted house. A house where weird things happen, strange noises, but don't let that worry you. I'll be with you to protect you. In this house is a wonderful, vast treasure, gold.
Gold.
A bag of gold. I have a map.
He's got the
which
map.
Which tells exactly where the gold is located.
What are we waiting for?
Let's go, boys.
Come on.
Hey, Bud. You try and get Bryant 4444.
For sure. Will you give me Bryant 4444?
There's the party.
There you are. There it is. By there, I just.
But what did you hang up for if you had the party? Get it again. I'll talk to him.
Just a minute.
Get it again. I'll talk to Joe right. Basso. Get it again.
Hello. Give me Bryant 4444.
There's the party.
There you are. There's nothing wrong with that phone.
Nothing at all.
Nothing at all.
Any time at all.
Miss.
Yes. Do you wish something more?
That's all, thank you. My check, please.
Very well, sir.
Seems as though I'm your last customer.
Oh, that's quite all right.
It was fine schnitzel. I enjoyed it very much.
Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it. You must come sometime and try our strudel and rindfleisch. That's real Viennese, you know.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
They certainly can cook in Vienna.
Oh, there's more than that in Vienna. Vienna is beautiful. There's singing and dancing and laughter.
Well, I hope to go there someday. Thank you very much. Good night.
Night. My Veen. Ist das meine Träume sein? Oh.
What, have you got Novotny in our USO show?
We're just going to ask a little.
You know, I want to tell you, Novotny, I've heard you at the Metropolitan. You were absolutely superb. You were wonderful.
Oh,
well, you know,
you
were great.
Miss Novotny, I at last have raised enough money to finish and complete my USO show.
What?
But
you're going to sing in a show, Novotny.
The show will not be complete unless you're in. Will you accept and help
thank
us out?
Thank you. Certainly, I'll be very happy.
Is that
wonderful? Thank you, Novotny.
Thanks a million.
Goodbye, darling. Goodbye. Let's give Miss Novotny, all you soldiers, a big hand. She's truly a wonderful girl. But now that you got the money to put your show on, I helped a little bit to get the money.
Well, you
may
didn't.
I sing in the show?
Now, Lou, please.
I got a beautiful thing.
Look.
A pretty girl.
Lou, just a minute.
It's like a melody.
Lou, please.
Novotny.
All right.
A pretty girl.
I have a lot of work to do on the stage here. I want to set my scenery and prepare the finale and everything. If you must sing, go down there and sing, will you, please?
I can sing then?
Yes. And not too loud. Don't annoy me, will you,
please? I won't sing too loud.
All right, open these curtains, boy. Open up.
Let's see here.
It's
like a melody.
A little higher. Joe, on the end there. Milk Kellner. Milk Kellner, that's it. Hold it, Milk. That's the boy. Now, over here. Up a little higher.
A pretty girl.
Little higher.
A pretty girl.
Milk Kellner, it's too high. Down a little.
A pretty girl.
Lower.
Oh, pretty good.
Lower, Milk.
Oh, pretty good. Like a melody.
All the way to the floor.
Oh, pretty good. It's close to the floor.
Pretty
good.
Hey, look, Milk, can you do me a favor? Up on this side here.
Oh, pretty good.
Up a little higher. Up on that side, a little higher.
Oh, pretty good.
Now, up on the left leg.
Oh, pretty good. It's like a melody.
Up on the right leg.
That hurts me next. And then.
Up on both legs.
Pretty girl. Can't do that.
pretty good.
Now, hold it. Just a little bit to the left. About a foot and a half to the left. Take your time now. Take your time.
Oh, pretty good.
Now, forward. A little, just a little bit. Not too much. A little bit forward.
Hold it. Oh, pretty good.
All right, now bring them together.
This length.
Now, forward a little more, about 2.5 feet forward. About 2.5 feet forward. Measure it out, boy.
Oh, pretty good. It's like a melody.
Little farther front.
That haunts me.
Little farther front.
Oh, pretty good.
A little farther front.
Baby.
Men, I can see by your smiling faces tonight you are just as happy as I am. After many trials and tribulations, Mr. Abbott has finally assembled his show, and you're about to witness the premier performance. They open with their own little opera called Don Juan Costello.
Tonight, we are being honored by the appearance of the great Senor Costello.
Oh, Senor Costello, the great bullfighter.
Senor Costello, the great lover. Oh, what a love.
Don Juan Costello is our ideal. He has a corner on sex appeal. Ladies are happy to style him on. The lovers are great, the feminine great.
I'm a Don Juan Costello, a lover quite mellow. Our lovers call me hello, my rivals turn yellow. My rivals turn yellow.
Greeno, Costello, greeno.
My rivals turn yellow.
Greeno, Costello. Greeno.
I'm colorblind. Women, they pursue me. Oh, how they woo me. They call yours truly when they feel drooly. Once I kissed a tootsie, swept her off her putsie. I kissed her so hard. Get your evening papers tonight. I kissed her so hard that she was overcome.
Overcome, overcome. She was overcome.
Overcome. Overcome by the kisses of my bubble gum. Toreadora, 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 Toreadora. That's enough of Spanish. That's a guy keep with the Toreador. I had it twice. That's enough.
Man.
Toreador. What's with the Toreador?
You're a bullfighter.
I'm a what?
A bullfighter. Can't you see it? You walk into the ring like a matador. You fight the bull like a picador.
And they'll carry me out like a cuspidor.
Go ahead. Your great lover has arrived.
Teresa?
Yes.
My silent love?
Yes.
Go keep her old man busy.
Ah, I go.
I feel like Limpy.
Ah, but as we say in Spanish, la bola, concilio, la vista. To you.
Thank you, sir, and a bowl of wet chili and a kisser to you, too.
Teresa!
my heart.
Oh, stop, I'm fickle.
I'm a slave to all your charms.
Oh, stop, you tickle, kid.
When you kiss me, my heart's wounds.
I learned to kiss from a blowing apple.
But my papa, he objects, he objects.
Her papa, he objects.
Wait till you hear.
Darling, I surrender. Hey, Robert!
You have not enough experience.
Please. I have a kiss coming here, and I'm going to get it from this kid. Has anybody got a jack handy?
Oh, darling.
You know, Clarissa, I used to be an osteopath. I love you, Clarissa. I love you, Clarissa.
Everybody hold it. Everybody hold it.
No, you love me.
I must be in love. I feel lousy.
I have heard of this love affair. You must get out of my daughter's hands.
I'm not ready yet to kick off. I am going to meet Tom Corbett, space cadet. Off I go into the wild blue yonder. Here I That's it.
Costello thrills me through and through.
But true, Papa, he's just a pain in the neck.
Here's what makes the dreams come true.
I got a bushel while Gregory's only got a peck.
A bushel and a peck, bushel and a peck. I love you.
Comes
up me. This is a chance. We better grab it. I'll grab her and you grab Abbott.
He'll get Abbott.
She'll get mellow with Costello.
The Colgate Comedy Hour has been presented by the Colgate Dental Cream to clean your breath while you clean your teeth and help stop tooth decay. And Palmolive Soap for a lovelier complexion in just 14 days. Abbott and Costello appear through the courtesy of Universal International Pictures Company. Look for their new picture, soon to be released. Abbott and Costello meet the Invisible Man. And now, good night for the Colgate Comedy Hour, which has been presented by the Colgate Palmolive Feed Company, makers of quality products since 1806.
Comedy Hour, starring with their guest stars Les Paul and Mary Ford, Jennigan Arno, Fred Darien, the Pied Pipers and Viola Vaughn, Abbott and Costello Show.